first create a new file in file new, and I set to this size with 1:1 ratio. Just click OK and change this canvas to the black color with bucket fill tool, or your shortcut is Shift B, and make sure the black color in the front, or you can click this to reset to black and white color. Then click on the canvas. Next, let's open the image in file. Open this layer, adjust this tiger, just click keep and scale it down with Shift S and hold Ctrl only to create a proportional scale. And present. Okay, now I want to take only this selection. Okay, now create a selection with rectangle tool. Click this icon, or the shortcut is R. Right, can create a square and then go to select and choose float. You see this floating selection, then create this create new layer. So what the float do is it create a new layer from a selection. So this is the selection and this original layer. So just delete this original layer, and with move tool you can move it to the center of the canvas. Now add some threshold to the image, I mean change it to black and white with paper print effect. So in colors choose this threshold, see, and you can try to adjust the value. I think this is good, and click OK. Change this white to some red color. So by clicking a new layer, pick this create new layer and name it red. Click OK. To the floated layer, right click, all part selection. While in selection, move to this red layer and change the color to this red. See this color code, click OK, and go to edit. Choose fillet foreground color, and let's change the layer mode to darken only. Okay, and deselect it in select and choose none, or the shortcut is Shift Ctrl A. I want to paint some areas with paint brush tool, or the shortcut is P. Okay, create new layer and animate. Okay, in this layer, so with paint brush tool can increase the hardness to 100 because I don't want to get the blurry result, so make the hardness full to 100. Now add a text, so press T and type, change the color to white and change the font to Railway Heavy, and let's increase the size to around 270. Now add some Y2K elements. So in file, just open, I choose this Y2K element. So I take this, so with the rectangle select tool, and I select this and go to select and choose float. Click this create new layer and move it to here. And if you want to change the color to white, you can invert it. In color, choose invert and Shift S to scale and hold Ctrl only to create a proportional scale, and add more. So with rectangle select tool, I choose this thunder. Make sure you in the original layer and go to select and choose float and click this create new layer. Move it to here, change the color to white and scale it down with Shift S. You can also create a guide, so you can drag from the top to make it properly aligned, and this too. And add more. And again, you can type a text again. So and just duplicate this. So with this duplicate tool, move it to here and change the text to a little rectangle in here. So create new layer and name it rectangle. So with this rectangle tool and create a selection and go to edit, choose fill with background color because I want to fill the color in this white color. And don't forget to deselect and select choose none. And last, you can add some texture in file. Open this layer and choose this. Just click keep and you can scale it down by pressing shift S and hold control only to create a proportional scale. Okay, make it fit to the canvas and press enter. And let's change layer mode to screen and can reduce the opacity if it's too much. Okay, and last, I want to add some wind text effect on the text. So in this hunt text and filters, choose distort and choose the wind. Okay, you can adjust it, the threshold and the strength. I just make a little around here and click OK. And this too, you can change to, I want to change to more ultra bold. And this too, so make sure you click the text layer and go to filters, distort and choose the wind. If it's too much, you can reduce the strength just a little. Okay, and this too. Okay, you can remove the gates to see the full result in view and uncheck the show gates. That's it. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next tutorial.